If you want to launch a 1 million meme coin on Binance Smart Chain, this video is for you. Today, I'm going to show you how to deploy your own BEP-20 token in Binance Smart Chain without coding anything in just a few minutes. I'm also going to show you how to create your own liquidity pool and how you need to set up everything in order to make your token success. When we are in Smithii tools, we need to make sure that we have Binance selected, okay, as we have different available, and our wallet connected. In this case, I have mine ready with BNB. Then we just need to go to the token creator tool. As you can see, it is audited. First, we're gonna create our token. It will be Jorge, and the supply will be 1 billion. 1 billion is the most used supply right now with memecoin. Then we can select our tax if we want to, okay? I think that a 4% will be not bad number. I will recommend you to see the trending memecoins on this moment and copy the supply and the tax. You can also set here the receiver wallet. By default, it will be the wallet you have connected, but you can put any other Binance Smart Chain wallet that you want to receive the fees. If we go to the advanced options, we can select all these options, okay? We have the airdrop mode. What airdrop mode makes is disable people from trading or transferring your token. So if you activate this airdrop mode, no one will be able to transfer your token. Anti-bot, this feature is really interesting. This prevents bots from trading, and it does function by essentially not allowing any wallet, any bot or any trader to trade twice in the same block. The anti-bot feature is really useful, and it essentially makes us prevent bots from trading or token. And we have the anti-whale that will allow us to put all these token limit per trade. It will be a maximum limit when trading our token. So essentially I won't be able to buy more than this amount I put here. For example, 10 millions, okay? Then we can set the time limit per trade in hours. It's a time frame that we will set between each transaction that a person will be able to do. For example, if I trade right now, if I put here 1 hour, until 1 hour, I won't be able to buy again. And we have the total limit per wallet, which will be the total amount a wallet can hold. For example, if I don't want anyone to hold more than the 10% of the supply, I will be able to put here 10 millions. And finish with the anti-whale settings, we have the active period. We can select how much time we want this anti-whale mode to be active. Okay, so for example, let's put a week. Once we have everything ready, okay, we'll just say anti-whale. We will click on create token. Okay, the total cost will be 0.24 BNB. So we click on create. It will open a transaction. Here we have the fees, okay, $3 so far right now, and the total amount to be paid. The first transaction of the token creator, and then we will pay another transaction to enable the anti-whale, okay? We will need to do two different transactions. This is the other one, confirm. Here we have the token address, so if we copy this, here we can paste the token address. Here we will be able to find the token. The previous one was the contract address, and this is our official page scan. Okay, here we have the information, the name, the ticker, the total supply, 1 billion, the amount of holder, which is me, and the total transfer, which is one from the smart contract. As you can see, this is really important. The contract is already verified, so you can rest assured that you won't need to verify again your contract address in order to add your own logo and metadata to your token, okay? By coming here and clicking update to info, we will be able to update the token image and some other information. So once this is done, we have also the anti-whale ready. As I said, if we need to manage anything, we can come here, set our token, and we will be able to manage different things. We can set a new tax address to receive for fee. We can also exempt addresses from the tax or deactivate that exemption, okay? And we can blacklist addresses from trading or token. You can also enable or disable the anti-bot previously when creating the token, and we can make the same with the anti-whale, okay? Here we can modify any of the settings we selected on the anti-whale. Now we have our token ready, and the next step would be allow people to trade or token. So for doing that, we need to create a liquidity pool. In this case, we can create it directly from Smithii tools as well. Here you just need to select the base token and the quote token. Okay, the base token will be our token, the token we have created, and the quote token will be a token with current value in the market. In this case, we can use BNB, USDC, or USDT. So once we have selected the pair of tokens, okay, the two tokens we are gonna create on the liquidity pool, we are gonna use on the liquidity pool, we need to add the liquidity. We need to select how much tokens are we going to into the liquidity. For Jorge, I'm at the whole supply, why not? I'm a 5 USDT. In this case, by default, Smithii selects the pool of 0.01 percentage fee on the trade. The cost of creating the liquidity pool will be 0.01 BNB plus the gas, and we will need to approve different transactions. The first one will be the expense limit. Here we have the second transaction to approve the limit of USDT. One important thing is that this tool whitelists our wallet address from needing to pay, okay, and to allow us to receive those taxes. So this is the next transaction, the third one. Then we will exempt the liquidity pool from anti-whale. There will be a limit on how much liquidity we need to we could add into the liquidity pool. And to finish, we will be creating the liquidity pool and our token will be available for trading on Uniswap. Here we have the fourth transaction. As you can see, the gas fee is nothing. So after the completing the transaction, we will see again the tool, but our LP is created. As you can see here, I can select my token and I will be able to trade it for USDT. So this is how easily you can create your own meme coin on Binance Smart Chain and send it to the moon. Okay, so that's it for today. If you have any doubt, feel free to drop a comment and I will answer as soon as possible. But that's all for today. Thank you so much for watching and see you in the next one. Bye bye.